for all the help and guidance along the way. A very big thank you to all the speakers, some of who have traveled far to be with us today. Professor Jamshid Choksi and his wife Carol, who have traveled all the way from Bloomington, Indiana. Mohammed Temtan Mirza and his wife Zinobia, who drove all the way down from London, Ontario. And Dr. Lauji Kama, who flew in from New Jersey. Thank you very much. Also, a very big thank you to our youth speakers, Afridi Chinoy and Sarosh Irani, for spending time doing research on their respective topics and preparing materials for their presentations. I also want to say a very big thank you to a lot of people who have worked behind the scenes, to Zinobia and Shahrukh Lala for hosting out-of-town guests, to Bepsi and Pacey Sanjana for helping out with registration and transportation, for Persis Sholapurwala and Pariza Chinoy for preparing some treats that you will be served today, and to Natasha Patel for helping out with the setup, and last but not the least, to my wife Shekufa, she's not here, and my mother-in-law Zareen for organizing and preparing the lunch, snacks, and refreshments. Thank you very much. Also at the same, also like to say a big thank you to the Farmington Community Library for allowing us to use the auditorium and facilities. Now, a few housekeeping things I'd like to mention. Please sign in if you already haven't. We would really like everybody to sign in and give us some contact, if an email or a phone number, anything that we can keep handy. Out through that door in the middle is a hallway, and there are restrooms over there. Okay, there also happens to be a water fountain over there, and I would strongly recommend everybody to use it. Okay, we do have water bottles in the back, but if you want to be eco-friendly and a good thirsty, I would recommend use that. There will be refreshments served in the back of the auditorium. We already have a little save and ravo served in the back, so whoever likes would, you know, be feel free to get up and help yourselves. The only thing I would really recommend and request is let only one person be talking in this auditorium at one time, except during the breaks, because sometimes it gets very hard for the audience to, you know, follow the presentations. Okay, at this stage, I would like to introduce a very important person who is attending our conference today. She is an interfaith and a women's rights and a social activist in the Metro Detroit area. She's also, I've known her since 2007, when our Zoroastrian community first participated in the annual World Sabbath for Peace and Religious Reconciliation. If some of you haven't attended it, I would very strongly recommend do attend. The next one is coming up on March 11th, which is a Sunday, and it's held at the Christchurch Cranbrook, and it's a beautiful location, and it's a great ceremony. This lady is also the founding member of WISDOM, which is Women's Interfaith Solutions for Dialogue and Outreach in Metro Detroit. Ladies and gentlemen, Gail Katz. Thank you, Gail. Our first speaker today is going to be Professor Jamshid Choksi. Around approximately 12:30, we will break for lunch, which will be served in the back of the auditorium. It'll be a light working lunch because we will have to try and be back in time to resume the afternoon session, which we hope to start around 1 o'clock. There's a slight change in the afternoon program. Afridi Chinoy has to leave early. So instead of speaking at 3:15, she will now start at 1 o'clock. And then she'll be followed by Sarosh Irani. At approximately 2:45-ish, we should be having a tea break. And then after that, we will have the Temtan Mirza talk, and then finally, it will be Lauji Kama's presentation. We will try and have a short Q&A session after each speaker. But, you know, we'll try to keep the questions down to a minimum because we want to stay on track. So without much ado, Professor Jamshid Choksi.